The tallest creature next to, of course, Brian Joubert. Not so, Brian. Exactly. There's a giraffe, everybody, as identified by the fact that it is browsing. That's how you know it's a giraffe, don't you, Brian?
Yes.
The identifying feature, the fact that it's eating leaves and is relatively large. It is a bull giraffe. We know that from the balding horns. I too have balding horns. Brian, you do not have balding horns, do you?
I have lovely, flowing, luscious locks.
You are very lucky to have lovely, flowing, luscious locks. Them days is over in my case. This giraffe is now offended, of course, that we have described him as having balding horns. I was also offended, Mr. Giraffe, until I got used to the idea. He looks deeply surprised. I don't know why I find that amusing. He's quite amusing. Let me just go back a little bit more. And a bit more. It's almost like he's looking at me as if to say, yeah, who do you think you are? How dare you comment about my lack of hair? Well, my friend, that is the way of things. And you must get used to it. Because I have to say, Mr. Giraffe, once you accept and embrace your baldness, you will feel so much better about it, I promise. I speak the truth to you. There, you see, he's now starting to agree with me, Brian. You see that, how he's moved his ears. He's coming to a state of acceptance now.
I think you just shocked him.
I think I did, to start with. But I think now that he's over the shock of the realization that he's losing his hair, he's going to be okay. We could call him the Jason Statham of giraffes. But then we'd be going too far with the joke, wouldn't we? It would be rather ridiculous. Yes. He also has beautiful eyelashes though, doesn't he, Brian? Yes. Very impressive eyelashes, my friend. He just looks so utterly astounded by our presence here. Come on. There we are. And again, just all around him, if Brian zooms out a little bit, you'll see the light shining through these tamburti trees. Now, the tamburti trees, not quite evergreen, but probably semi-deciduous, which means they lose their leaves periodically, and then they come back again. And with the giraffe, one of the few animals that's able to eat the poisonous sap of the tamburti. Not many can do that. A very fine fellow indeed. We've yet to make it to Biffleswick Dam, everybody. We keep being stopped by these animals. Our species list today, of course, Brian, vast. Impala, nyala, kudu, giraffe, waterbuck, elephant.
Our cup doth overflow.
And crested bobbit. There he is. The classic giraffe tilt. Very nice, Brian.
Thank you.
Yes.
I do what I can.
You do. Very well. Let me go back slightly more, everybody. Oh, beautifully framed. Yes, no, that look is definitely one of disdain on his face, everyone. He's not even chewing the cud. He might be, he's looking behind us at something. I think it's just the swaying of the trees in this gentle breeze. And again, you cannot hear any kind of bird for some reason, and I just don't understand. I don't get why there aren't any birds calling this afternoon. There weren't any yesterday afternoon either, you know. he's heard something. Oh, very good idea. Patricia, you say maybe I can tell him what tree helps with baldness. Well, I can tell him for free that no tree helps with baldness, but I can tell him that apparently, Mr. Giraffe, I'll call you Jason from now on, apparently the Papia capensis or jacket plum tree does in fact help with baldness. So what you can do is you can take it, rub it on the top of your horns and see if the luscious locks of your youth don't return. I personally think you should just embrace it. Yes, he's very shocked. Okay, let's move on to Biffleshook Dam. We're not far from there. Good luck. That is the most bemused giraffe I've ever seen. Hello, Arbor. You want to know if a giraffe has ever behaved in an aggressive fashion towards me? No. I have never seen a giraffe behave in an aggressive fashion towards a human being, and I have been within 1 meter at one stage. I lay on the ground and let one come and say hello to me, and it came to within a meter and was looking at us. So, no, I have never seen that. They will become aggressive if they are sufficiently threatened. So, with lions and with leopards, they will absolutely become quite nasty. They kick exceptionally well with both feet, front and back, and lions can often be killed when trying to hunt giraffe. If the giraffe aims a well-placed kick at a lion's head, the lion will often be killed. So that does happen if you threaten them sufficiently, but I've never threatened a giraffe to that point. That said, I do know of people who've been hurt by a giraffe inadvertently, especially at night. So they watch them being hunted by lions, and then the giraffe, of course, if you're shining a spotlight, becomes totally panicked. It can run at the car and won't see the car, and it'll just run straight over it. Now, that's a 1.5-ton animal in the case of a big giraffe. And so you can imagine 1.5 tons hitting a car like this. And because it's so gangly and long, it basically just folds over whatever it runs into. And so you can get yourself and your guests into quite a lot of trouble. So you do hear the odd story like that, but that's about the sort of level of damage and how damage is done by a giraffe if it happens. Right, we're arriving at the Great Waterhole. Hello, Brock. You want to know about the different kinds of giraffes that you find around Africa and how many kinds there are? Well, it's a bit of a moot point. Lots of people debating how many kinds of different giraffes we get, but I'll show you a picture of all of them. I think the general consensus at the moment is about 9. But it varies between 7 and 13. Now, while you are looking at Biffleshook Dam, I shall retrieve pictures of all these different kinds of giraffes, all of which are the same species, according to some. Some say they're different species. Gosh, I just find it rather confusing. The one that we get here, everybody, is called the southern giraffe. Let me just find them all for you. This book I've got is wonderful because it's got all the different pictures of the different kinds that we get. Luckily, nothing has fallen prey to the mud yet. Right, can you see that, Brian? Is that fine? Okay, so we get the reticulated giraffe. Well, they're all in Latin. It's going to be difficult to understand. That's the one we get. That's the southern giraffe. Then you get the reticulated giraffe, the Angolan giraffe, which should be Angolensis. It is Angolensis. I don't see Angolensis suddenly. Which isn't... Oh, there it is. That's the one down at the bottom of the page there. Angolensis. Then the one up near sort of Tanzania and Kenya, which is the blue one. which is called Tipakuski. Basically, that one there, if you can see that. I think that's also called the Maasai giraffe. And then you get the reticulated giraffe. That's also up in sort of East Africa. Yeah, and a light morph reticulated giraffe. So lots of different kinds. I think they've got seven here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. They've got 8 in this particular example. Right. So those are the different kinds of giraffes. But like I say, some people say they're species, some people say they're subspecies, some people say that there are 13 of them. I don't think they really care. I think the point is that they can probably all interbreed. Maybe the West African ones will struggle to interbreed with the Southern and East African ones, but I think you'll find that they could probably hybridize very successfully, and there'd be no sort of lack of species integrity, if you like, through that. I think it's just a fact that they're different colors, different races from the different geographical positions in which they find themselves. Really not much going on here. Hello, Gracie. Thank you very much, you say. Old is beautiful. And in, what is it? Old is beautiful, and in boys it's cute. Is that correct, Gracie? Oh, and the bald is beautiful. Thank you very much, Gracie. I think you're absolutely bang on correct. Well done. Now, let's go back across to Brent Leo Smith and find out how he's going in the Great Plains.